I was first introduced to Ernest Hemingway as a child. My American literature teacher gave the class The Old Man and the Sea. And there were a few stories that I remember as a child which so captured my imagination that I was in that book. You know, it's one of those experiences. And part of that was his dream of coming to the place where that story is told. I wasn't sure where Cuba was. I probably ran to a map to try to find it, you know?
El Viejo y el Mar, original de Ernest Hemingway. Fue el tiempo y a lo que habían visto. Los pescadores que aquel día habían tenido éxito, habían llegado y habían limpiado sus agujas y la llevaban tendida sobre dos tablas, lo cual era la peor forma de la mala suerte. Y por orden de sus padres, el muchacho había salido en otro bote que cogió tres buenos peces la primera semana.
Vamos a llevar las cosas a casa, dijo el muchacho.
The most touching thing for me about The Old Man and the Sea is the relationship between the boy and the old man. Now, I saw myself as that boy, you know. And then this desperate sort of relationship he has with the big fish, you know, out at sea, where that fish becomes almost human.
No, pero nosotros sí, ¿verdad? Sí, dijo el muchacho. ¿Me permite invitar una cerveza en la terraza?
First he catches the fish, and then he tries to protect the fish, even after he's caught it. When the sharks come in, tear it apart, and he comes back with nothing more than a skeleton.
Cuando el viento soplaba del este, el hedor se extendía a través del puerto, procedente de la fábrica de tiburones.
Pero there was something very tender about the man, and as I grew up and got to know more about Hemingway, this one story remains in my mind as one of the more sensitive of his books.